are at a new session at Graduate Guru. Our topic currently we are doing is accounting from incomplete records. We are on question number 9 presently, which we are starting today. So first, let's read the question. You are provided with balance sheet of Miss Asha on 1st April 2018. Cash transactions for the year ended 31st March 2019 and summary of other trading transactions. So, हमें तीन चीजें दी गई हैं. One is the opening balance sheet. 1st April को जो opening statement of affairs हम बनाते हैं generally, that will not be needed because it's already given to us. They have also given us cash transactions in the form of a cash account. Receipts, payments, tallied account है. So, again, वहां से हम सिर्फ we'll give the second effect for that because it's already a tallied account. And then there are some summary of other transactions for which we will be giving double effect because that is not in any account. The balance sheet has liability side, bank overdraft, creditors, bills payable and capital. An asset side, we have cash, bills receivable, debtors, stock, equipments and computer. So, these are our assets and liabilities. Now, when I see the cash transactions, as I said, tallied account हमें दिया हुआ है. So, जो bank overdraft हमने liability में देखा, that is already given as by balance brought down. Okay? So, on the credit side, it's an opening balance because it's a liability, bank overdraft है. And same way, जो asset में हमने cash देखा, that is also there on the receipt side. Two balance brought down. So, वो दोनों opening balances have been already recorded in the cash account. दो effect already हो चुका है. So, I will not give any more effect for that. Other receipts in the cash transactions are two debtors. So, that means this is the amount which we have received from the debtors. Two bills receivable. That means the amount which we have received from the bills receivable which got honored. Two sales cash. So, cash sales are also there which are given and two capital introduced. Payment side, we have salaries, wages, bills payable, creditors. Salaries, wages are expenses. Bills payable will go to bills payable account. These are the payments that we have made for our bills. Creditors ka payment hai, rent hai, sundry expenses, drawings that will affect your capital. Investment in 12% bonds. So, that means during the year, we have purchased some new investment. Rate diya hai uska, 12% bonds hai wo. And there is a date given in the bracket. So, obviously that date will help us to calculate the interest for the year. And then we have closing balance. Both cash and bank are on the credit side, closing balance. That means it's a positive balance. Both will come on the asset side on our closing balance sheet. Now, other transactions are credit sales is given, discount allowed. So, that will also affect our debtors. Discount allowed is always with the debtors because we allow the discount to the debtors. Purchase is given and discount received is given. Bills receivable drawn. These are the new bills which we drew during the year or jo hume accept hokar mil gaye hain. Okay? Bills payable accepted. Waise hi humne jo bills accept kiye hain and we have given to our creditors, those are given. And they have given us stock on 31st March. That's our closing stock. Provide 5% for doubtful debts and depreciation on equipments at 10%, computers at 30%. So these are additional adjustments jo hum जैसे final accounts में उसका effect देते हैं, वैसे ही यहाँ पर देंगे. And they've asked us to prepare trading and P&L account. This is quite a direct sum. Most of the things given to us. What we don't have is closing balances of debtors, creditors, bills receivable and bills payable. So that is what we are going to find by preparing our accounts. So हमें ये चार accounts बनाने पड़ेंगे, which we have prepared and kept. Debtors, bills receivable, creditors, bills payable, and of course for our final accounts as we need trading, P&L and balance sheet. So let's begin the sum. First, I am going to empty my opening balance sheet. Okay. So let's begin. As I said, bank overdraft or cash, already second effect de diya hai. So I'll be starting with creditors. So I'll go to my creditors account. Opening balance is always on the credit side. So I'll record that on the credit side as by balance brought down. Okay, we are going to give only one effect kyunki hum direct opening statement of affairs se we are taking the amount. So creditors 1,80,000. Same way we have bills payable of 80,000. Bills payable account mein credit side pe by balance brought down 80,000. Okay, then we have capital. Capital, we don't prepare an account. Closing balance sheet mein, I will write it as my opening balance. So 19,90,000 is my capital. So I'll put it in the inner column, usme plus minus hoga. Okay, we'll leave space. Coming to the asset side, cash as I said already recorded. Bills receivable and debtors we have. So debtors first we'll record. Opening balance on the debit side. Debtors is 1,95,000. And bills receivable is 1,25,000. So bills receivable account mein two balance brought down. 1,25,000. Then we have stock. Jo opening balance sheet mein stock hai, that is nothing but our opening stock, which will go to trading. So trading account. To opening stock. The amount is 876,500. And then we have equipments and computer, jisme adjustment mein sirf depreciation hai. So I'll directly put it in my balance sheet. Equipment is 5,85,000. I'll leave space for depreciation and same way computer 5 lakhs. Leave space for depreciation here also. Balance sheet is empty. So opening balance sheet done. Now we come to the cash transactions and there first I'll see the receipt side. We have to give second effect. So receipt side, jo bhi debit side pe hai, uska second effect will be on the credit side. So we have two debtors. So in debtors, I will write by cash 14,50,000. So by cash bank account, we can say 14,50,000. Then we have bills receivable 5 lakhs. So again, bills receivable. Credit side, second effect by cash bank. Five lakhs. Then we have two sales, cash. Cash sales hai. Sales are always recorded in the trading account. So we have cash sales of 36,85,000. So here I'll write buy sales, cash, 36,85,000 and we'll leave space for credit sales. And we have on the receipt side, last thing, two capital introduced, 5 lakhs. Capital hai, new capital will be added to that. So add introduced 5 lakhs, add karke total niche hi lenge hum 24,90,000. Now we come on the payment side, and first is the opening balance of overdraft, that's already done. And then we have salaries. So salaries we'll record in the PNL, 12,45,000. So expense side pay PNL mein two salaries, 12,45,000. Then we have wages, 10,79,000. Wages goes to trading. So I'll leave space for purchase and I'll write down two wages. 10,79,000. Then we have bills payable. Again, second effect denge, yahan par credit side pe hai. So there I'll put it on the debit side. So we'll go to bills payable and we'll write down two cash bank. Amount is 7,15,000. That's done. And same way we have creditors. So creditors of 7,35,000. I'll put it on my debit side of creditors. Two cash bank account. 7,35,000. Okay. Then we have rent, we have sundry expenses, all these are normal expenses which will come in the PNL. So rent 6 lakhs, to rent 6 lakhs and we have sundry expenses, to sundry expenses. Sundry expenses is 90,000. Then we have drawings. Jaise capital introduce yahan pe kiya hai, waise hi drawings aa jayega. So minus drawings. Amount is 7,15,000. I'll subtract and put it inside only. Net profit add hoga usme baad mein. 24,90,000 minus 7,15,000. We get 17,75,000. Then we have investment in 12% bonds. That's an asset. Hum jab kisi mein invest karte hain kisi company mein, it's my asset. So I'll put it on the asset side. Investments in 12% bonds. The amount of investment is 2 lakhs. I'm putting it in the inner column because as I said, we have information to calculate our interest. So we'll come to that a little later. And then we have closing balance of cash and bank. So again, asset side, cash, bank. Cash is 14,500. And bank balance is 7,10,000. Okay. So this finishes our cash account also. Yahan par receipts have been posted, payments have been posted, one effect given. So this account also empty. Now we come to other transactions aur wahan par hame double effects deni hai. So first is credit sales. Credit sales entry is debtors account debit to sales account. So, pehle debtors account mein, here, my debtors account to credit sales. Amount is given 20,35,000. And where do we take the sales? In the trading account, we have left space. So, credit sales 20,35,000. We can take the total outside. So 36,85,000 plus 20,35,000 gives me 57,20,000. Then we have discount allowed. Discount kise allow kiya hai? Debtors ko. Okay. So when we allow discount, discount is an expense. discount account debit to debtors account. So debtors mein credit side pe buy discount allowed. Amount given is 10,000. It's an expense. P&L mein second effect on the debit side. To discount allowed 10,000. Then we have purchases. Obviously, it's given as separate transaction. So, this is credit purchase. So, creditors may, we will have the effect on the credit side. Buy credit purchase. Credit purchase amount is 15 lakhs. And we have a discount received of 5,000. Again, that is related to my creditors. Creditors account debit to discount received. It's our income. So, discount over here is credited to discount received 5,000. Income hai hamara. So, P&L mein credit side pe. I'll leave space for our gross profit. By discount received 5,000. Then we have bills receivable drawn. So that means ye naye bills hai jo during the year we have drawn on the debtors. Debtors give us the bill. So bill comes in. Bills receivable account debit to debtors account. So let's go to bills receivable first. On the debit side, to debtors account, and in the debtors account, buy bills receivable account. The amount is 5,45,000. And same way, there is bills payable accepted. Humne accept karke bills payable creditors ko diya hai. So, creditors account debit to bills payable amount is 7,50,000. So, in creditors account to bills payable account 7,50,000. And second effect in the bills payable on the opposite side by creditors account 7,50,000. Okay. And then finally they have given us closing stock of 7,65,000. We know our two effects. One is balance sheet. So stock 7,65,000 and another is trading account credit side by closing stock 7,65,000. Okay, now we have our adjustments, and before we go to that, we should not forget our interest on bonds. So let's calculate our interest. We will add the interest here. It's our income. Investment pe hume interest milne wala hai. So I'll write it over here. Buy interest on bonds. Let's show the working here. The amount of bonds is 2 lakhs. Rate given is 12%. And when did we buy them? October. 1st October. So, October se March, 6 months ka interest is due, which is not received. Hame kahin bhi cash account mein interest nahi dikha hai. So, that's why I have treated it as an asset, jo hame interest milne wala hai. So, here into 6 upon 12, let's calculate it. 2 lakhs into 12% into 6 divided by 12, we get 12,000 as the interest. So I'll add that over here. Take this amount outside. 2,12,000. Okay. Now we have provide 5% for doubtful debts. Debtors balance I still have to find out. So now let's first close and then we'll do these last three adjustments of doubtful debts and depreciation. So ek by ek we'll close the account. Simple hai yahan pe, everything is given. Only thing missing is the closing balance. So I need to find my closing balance. I'll close the debtors. Debit side will be heavy. Let's take a total of the debits. 1,95,000 plus 20,35,000. We get 22,30,000. Bring that here. Subtract our credits, 14,50,000, 10,000 and 5,45,000. I get a closing balance of 2,25,000. This is nothing but my balance carried down. Okay. Same way, we'll close our bills receivable. Again, what is missing is the closing balance. So let's take a total of our debits. 1,25,000 plus 5,45,000. I get 6,70,000. Subtract our 5 lakhs. Balance will be 1,70,000. That's our closing balance. So that is by balance carried down. Similarly, close the creditors. Creditors and bills payable, dono mein credit side heavy hoga. So I'll take the credit side total. 1,80,000 plus 15 lakhs. 16,80,000. And subtract our debits from that. So minus 7,35,000 minus 5 minus 7,50,000. We get 1,90,000 as our closing balance. Two balance carried down. And finally, bills payable, same way. Total 80,000 plus 7,50,000. 8,30,000. And subtract our debit of 7,15,000. We get 1,15,000 as our closing balance. Two balance carried down. Now all these four balances I'll post to my balance sheet. So first is debtors. Debtors on the asset side. We'll put it in the inner column. There is an adjustment. So 2,25,000. Leave a line for the adjustment. Creditors is 1,70,000 on the liability side. Here also I'm leaving a line and then writing creditors of 1,70,000. I'm sorry. Creditors is 1,90,000. We have bills receivable. Bills receivable is 1,70,000. And we have bills payable. Bills payable of 1,15,000. So all four balances recorded. Okay. Now I have an adjustment. Provide 5% for doubtful debts. So debtors mein
less reserve for doubtful debts,
RDD, 5% of the amount which is given. So 2,25,000 into 5%,
we get 11,250.
Subtract and take it outside.
213,750.
Okay. I take this RDD, it's an expense. Generally, hum use bad debts mein add karte hain, but yahan pe bad debts nahi hai. So, I'll show it as a separate expense in my P&L. 11,250 to RDD on debtors. 11,250. Same way we have depreciation. Depreciation on equipments is 10%. So, equipment mein less depreciation. $58,500. And computer, the depreciation is 30%.
So, minus depreciation, it will be
1,50,000. We'll just check. 5 lakh into 30%.
1,50,000 will be the depreciation. Minus, here I have 3,50,000.
And for my equipment, I have 526,500. We'll take the depreciations to P&L. So, to depreciation, equipments and computers, equipments is 58,500, computers is 1,50,000.
So, we've recorded our depreciation, all adjustments done. Now, we just have to start closing our final accounts. So, we begin by closing the trading account first.
We have not taken our purchases over here. So, let's bring our purchases from the creditors account. 15 lakh purchases. There is no cash purchase. So, only one purchase, that is credit purchase. 15 lakhs. And now we can close our trading account to find our gross profit.
Let's take the total of the credits. 57 lakh 20 and 7 lakh 65 thousand. We get 64 lakhs 85 thousand. And from that, we subtract our debits. Debits of 876,500, 15 lakhs and 10,79,000. We get 30,29,500 as our gross profit. We bring that down to P&L by gross profit. Now let's close our P&L and find our net profit. Total of the credits, 30,29,500 plus 5,000 plus 12,000, 30,46,500. We bring that on this side. And we subtract our debits from that, all our expenses. 12,45,000, 6,90,000, 10,000, 11,250, 58,500 and 1,50,000. 8,81,750. That's our net profit. We have to take that net profit to our balance sheet in the capital. ₹8,81,750. Let's finally close our capital. 26,56,750. Let's take a total of our balance sheet. ₹1,90,000 I'll add to my capital and ₹1,15,000. We get 29,61,750 on the liability side. Let's check if it's the same on the asset side. 526,500, 3,50,000, 2,12,000, 14,500, 7,10,000, 7,65,000, 213,750, and 1,70,000. Yes, we get the same total. 29,61,750. That's our balance sheet total. Our balance sheet has tallied. So we've done everything correctly. Okay. Take down this sum. So we'll wind up this session for now. Next session, we'll be taking up a slightly difficult and a different sum. So please go on practicing your formats and revise your entries for sure. Thank you.